next year.
The nation's mortgage industry could use a little heat right now. The Federal Reserve reported today that mortgage originations tumbled 11% last year after lending rates ticked a little bit higher and there was a sharp drop in loan refinancings.
More signs of the choppy recovery in housing today. Sales of existing homes took an unexpected turn for the worse in August, down nearly 2%, the first decline in 5 months. Realtors are blaming the drop on a sharp pullback by investors. But could that really be the only cause? Diana Olick has the story.
They came.
165.
They bought. They pushed prices higher. But now large-scale investors in single-family homes are cutting off the cash to the housing market.
I think the investors are concerned with a potential rise in the interest rate.
Realtors blame a drop in investor purchases for the unexpected drop in August home sales, down nearly 2% from July and down over 5% from a year ago. But the drop in the share of investor purchases is far more steep, just 12% of buyers in August, down from 28% 4 years ago. This does not, however, mean investors are necessarily selling.
In our rental business, we see much better results than we ever imagined.
Not when rents are skyrocketing thanks to surging demand from millennials.
They look at life differently. They live differently. Their investment expectations are dramatically different. And they're not looking at a house as being an investment vehicle anymore.
It's not that millennials don't aspire to home ownership someday. It's just that they're getting married and having children later in life, and those are the two biggest drivers of home ownership. They also have a lot more of these to choose from, single-family rentals. And they don't see the same stigma attached to renting that previous generations did.
I would expect that we're going to see higher levels of rentership for at least the next 5 or 6 years, after which I hope that those levels decrease and people learn to get into sustainable home ownership again.
The exodus of investors could mean less competition for younger buyers now, but it remains to be seen if more of those younger buyers will be willing to play. For Nightly Business Report, I'm Diana Olick in Washington.